Yeah, good afternoon everyone.
Good afternoon.
My topic is how to find your passion. It is very strange that most of the students in our India don't know what do they want to be in their future. Because that's a very scary thought for our generation basically. Because in 18-22 years we have to discover ourselves. For discovering ourselves, it is not a one-day process. You suddenly realize, you just wake up one day and suddenly realize, oh, I want to do that in my life. It just doesn't happen, my friends. Actually, it is a process. You have to learn it. You have to fight for it. You have to study for it. For knowing yourself, in which field you are so good and you are so talented that you can be a good master. You can teach by yourself, that is alone, not by any teacher or somebody else. What is a passion? What do you mean by a term passion? Can someone tell me about passion?
Doing something out of interest.
What is?
Doing something out of interest.
Right, Mr. Venkat. Passion is a term, is a thing in which we are so interested in it that we can't wait for anybody to teach us, and we are good at the end in it that we become master and teach somebody else. For selecting a passion, it is whatever anything you took something, but it should not be associated with what our society thinks, what our parents think, and what our people around us think. Because when it comes to our society, they only think engineering and medical are the two best things for any student. For any student which did not take engineering or medical, he should not be passionate about anything. Is it what we have sent for this earth? No, my friend. Probably someone be a good carpenter, people around us. Why he is good cutting a tree? That's his talent. If someone became a great comedian, people around him, how he managed to earn some money? How will he manage? I don't know yet. But if it is talent or it's passion, I am damn sure he makes a lot of money from it. It is the age between the 18 to 22 years. It is the age where we find ourselves not reading the engineering books and becoming bookworms. Actually, it is the process. Actually, it is the time where we find ourselves. To find ourselves, what is the best technique? You know, all people. What is the best technique to you know yourself? The experience one, Mr. Toastmaster.
Understand.
No one. Actually, the best process to knowing yourself is traveling. Traveling means taking a holiday, go to Goa and sit on the beach and wondering what is going on in my life. No, my friend, traveling means I observer, a self observer, like you watching a television, you watching a TV in which you are sitting in a corner and seeing what will happen, what will next happen. You travel alone. Howsoever you go anywhere, you do not need a lot of money for it. You just need a backpack, a ticket, and our country India is wide enough to go anywhere. You go to Kerala, you go to South, you go to Northeast, anywhere you want. But only things remember that travel, and travel alone. If you travel alone, you talk to strangers, you talk to random peoples. You know a lot of experiences from them. After traveling, you saw in yourself that in the small world in which you are living, it's not so small. It's really massive, my friend. It's really massive. Everyone is going to die here. And we back to our God, which is sit around our the sky. When we are going to die, we all know we are in an universe where there are millions of planets, and the only planet is Earth, where there are flies. There are millions of species, millions of living things, but only one living thing, that has ability to think, that has ability to passionate, that is we the human race. We are gift of our God, Almighty God, and we treat this gift by knowing ourselves, by knowing our passion, by knowing passionate about our life. In the remember one thing, in the recent upcoming 60 to 70 years, we are all going to die in this room, in the whole world, which are born in the 90s, we are all going to die. And when in our in dead beds, our nurse comes in and say, "Sir, it's over. You have probably 5 minutes more." We sit. "Oh, yeah, it's over. I am going to die." "Nurse, yes, sir, you are going to die." "Oh my God, I have to jump from that plane. I didn't do that. I have to confess my love before that girl. I didn't do that. I just wasted my life." "No, my friend, this is not answer which is given by us. When we in our dead bed, lying in our beds, approaching to death, the only answer, when nurse come to us, "Sir, you are going to die in 5 minutes. You have regret anything?" The only answer we think, we give, "No, I lived my life in my fullest and my best capabilities." That's all. Thank you.